from this computer. So getting recorded now. It's getting recorded. You guys know?
Yes, sir.
Sure. Okay. Okay, got it. Let me copy this assignment before I make any change. Okay, I copied it. Who gave this? Bhuvanesh, you gave it, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let me see. Tools and simulators. Open VBA after run. Save it. Run. It's running for me, man. See, it's running. It ran for me. Okay, so let's see. I'll show you how to do the analysis, right? ModelTech has those coverage tools. I'll start explaining them one by one. How do you get the information automatically from the tool? Have you covered all the lines, all the statements, all the branch, right? When you install the ModelTech, I'll show you all those things. Right? You have to install the ModelTech first, right? Okay, so reset. I'll show you. Let's do manually. The clock has to toggle. Are you toggling clock? Yes, you are toggling clock. The reset has to go to 0 to 1, right? Your reset is going to 0 to 1? Yes, it is going. And 1 to 0 also is happening. So that'll get covered. So this is called toggle coverage, right? And this is your covering. So state equal to S1, it will happen by this condition is true. This is becoming true. So all this will get included, right? This case state, S1. So you'll go to S1 state. And from S1, you can go to S1 or S2, right? If you're in S1 state, what is your S1 state? If TA equal to 1, right, from S1 state, you should be in the S1 state, you should also go to S2 state. Where is that we are doing? Reset is removed. I think you'll see the waveform, right? So one clock, you should remain the same state. So both the conditions should get covered, that's what I'm saying, right? You understand? Bhuvanesh, right? All the lines should get executed. There's a TA, while you're in the S1 state, so for some time the TA has to be 1, for some time the TA has to be 0, okay? Then only both the branches will get executed, okay? It's called branch coverage. I'm teaching you some of the verification concepts today, right? So it's called branch coverage. So when you're in S1 state, you should you should keep TA to 0 for a couple of clocks, then you should make the TA to 1. So then in both the cases will get covered here, okay? Understand? And S2 is only one clock, so there's no condition. Automatically go to S3. S3 again, you have to wait for some time, the S4, the S3 state. Is this correct, man? S3 TB gone, it's going to the same state, right? Otherwise, going to S4. Is it correctly coded? Bhuvanesh?
Sir, I sent another code, sir.
What? Sir. Which code you sent?
In the chat box, sir.
Let me check. The chat, man. No, it's not there in the chat box. How do you check the chat box? I'm very poor in the Zoom. Okay, here somewhere. Oh, chat. Okay, I'm seeing the chat window. Okay, which one should 36K3, right? That one? Okay. Okay, I opened it. This is case. Let me copy this. So keep some good names like this, man. Right? It's very difficult otherwise. The naming has to be consistent. Okay, let's see here. So the test bench also is okay. So we see reset should be, clock is always toggling, reset is toggling. And when reset is 0, reset is 1, both should happen, right? When clock should toggle, both should happen, and this will happen automatically, I suppose. Okay, this will always happen. I hope you are waiting till all the values will happen. When wow, very nice code, man, very compact. Always a TBTRCR, all the TBTRCR and both, all the things should get toggled, right? You're toggling all. Okay, here any code coverages in this one? Let us see. I don't know how to do the coverage here. Let us see. Okay, anyway. Yeah, TB, TA, or CR, all the three has to toggle. So X equal to TB and CR. So you should see that this condition has to become true. Manually, you have to make sure. You do this manually for today. Tomorrow, the tools will help you, right? So you should make sure that this condition also becomes true. All the your three conditions here, right, Bhuvnesh? Correct?
Yes, sir.
These are odd conditions. So your test bench should exercise such that TB and SOD become true sometimes. Sometimes this should become true. Sometimes this should become true. All the three combinations should exercise. Okay? So then only you know your test bench has been robust. Otherwise, you have not covered the entire design. There will be something called coverage hole will come. The verification methodology, you'll see all these things. When Palaniappan is going to talk on the webinar, right? He'll talk about something called coverage. So this is called expression coverage. Right? So this expression has to become true. There are three ways it can become true, correct? X can be the value with the three possible conditions, correct? So all the three conditions has to become true. Then only is this particular logic is fully verified. Correct? Let's say you are not verifying it. I verify only one combination. You verified. Let's say this is a chip. You are making a chip and you are sending it to manufacturing. When you test practice in the lab, other conditions can become true, but no, it may not work. And the condition happens in the real life, right? Agreed? There may be a bug here or here. Unless you thoroughly tested all the combinations, how do you know that your design is going to work? Understand, guys? Raise your hand if you understood. One,
sir,
two,
can you three. Tell again, sir?
Yeah, I'll explain for one. Yeah, I had three hands. Okay, let's ask them who understood. Okay, Shankar, can you explain? Somebody raise the hand, please explain. No, I don't want to explain. Okay, I'll explain, man. Don't worry. Right? So there are three conditions here, right? What I'm saying, for X to become true, there are three possibilities. One, two, and three. Correct? This is one. This is the first possibility. Second, there are OR gate, right? This is OR gate. This is the first gate, first input to the OR gate, second input to the OR gate. This is the third input to the OR gate. Okay. So you have to make sure that all the three combinations are exercised in your test bench. So TB and CR, both should be one sometime. TA should be zero and CR should be one sometime. And TA should be zero and TB should be one sometime. All the three combinations should work. Let's say you verified only this combination to test bench, okay? You forgot to verify these two. You only made this and you verified it. So you say it is working. You made a chip out of this particular design. When you test in the lab, now let's assume there is some mistake. Instead of AND, I put an OR here by mistake. Right? Let's assume something. I put something else. Right? And since it's not verified, when the real way, you get all kind of inputs will come, right? When that comes, this will not work as you expected. Right? So that's unless you verify all combinations, you will not know. So there are certain tools available for that. It's called coverage analysis. There are tools available called coverage. So this is called expression coverage. And this is called branch coverage. You have this branch, right? If something, else something. So that's like a branch. And you have state machine coverage. So all the states has to be covered. All the possible state transition has to be covered. Right? From S0, you should go to B in this one for some time. You should go to S1. From S1, you should remain in S1. Both the branches should be covered. From S2, should be in S2. You should go to S3. These are all the conditions has to be covered. Right? Every single line has to be covered. Here also, everything. Every single line, all combinations here also has to be covered. It is very difficult to do it manually, I agree. But now you do manually. For now, that's how you learn. You do it manually. Once you go to the model tech, there will be tools to that extract the information automatically. It will tell you this particular line is not covered when you run your test bench. Then you have to go and analyze that coverage report. Then you know that this particular line is not executed. You should go and modify your test bench to add a test case to cover this particular condition. Right? You're able to follow now, Pawan?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
How about others? Girish?
Yes, sir.
Girish, you followed?
Yes, sir.
Sriram?
Sir, I came in between the class, sir. Sorry, sir.
Okay, no problem. So I'll have somebody explain. Yeah, Ishwar, why don't you explain to Sriram? Ishwar, please explain. It's okay to do mistakes. Just explain. You have to talk. Why? What you don't know? Huh? Oh, Yeshua doesn't understand. Okay. Who understood? Bhuvnesh, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you explain? See, this is what I'm asking. Unless you write your own notes, I've been telling right from the day class, none of you do that. If somehow you're following my thing, I'll be so happy. I will write it and give it. You will not become successful engineer unless you want to become good. I know all of you are ambitious, so generally you follow my instructions. Because I've done this like by painful, like we have spent so much hard toil and we have learned, but we have done mistakes and we have learned it actually, right? So I don't want to do the same mistake. That's why I'm sharing all the tips and tricks. But you do that, you apply it to your college, you share with everybody, right? Then definitely you will become successful. And people will love, you'll get a job. I'm telling you, man, I'm telling you, even before you finish my course, I'll definitely people will love and they'll give you a job automatically. You'll get multiple job offers. I'm telling you. If you just follow each one of my instructions, you just tell you, do everything, whatever I tell you, I'll give it in writing. You definitely, you'll get more than one job. You can pick and choose what you want. Okay. If you follow everything, it'll definitely will happen. I'm very confident about myself. But if you don't follow my instructions, what is it I can do, man? I cannot do anything. Okay, Bhuvanesh, over to you.
Sriram, there is a thing called code coverage in which all the possible cases should be covered.
There, okay.
In line 40, there is some expert in X. We should cover all possible cases in X. Then only there is three conditions. TB, and of counter not T and of counter TA and of TB and these three expressions are so we should verify that the three conditions are satisfied for all these cases that is for the last you should write test bench to cover all the possible cases.
So what will happen, Bhuvanesh, if all the cases are not covered in test bench, what will happen?
It may cause effect. We cannot prove that the design is completed, sir.
Yes, there'll be bugs, right? Let's say you're buying a mobile phone. Let's say the mobile phone has so many features, right? Let's say somebody doesn't test the Wi-Fi feature. Only 4G works. So you buy a phone. In the shop, you are there. Now you switch on the data, everything works. You come home and you connect to a Wi-Fi network. Now Wi-Fi doesn't work. What will happen then? You tell me. What will you do? You live with it, or what will you do? What will be your reaction, Kishwar? You will run to the shop. You will yell at the shop, right? Won't you shout at that person?
Right? Yes, sir.
No other way. Shout. Yeah, even I'll shout, right? We'll not. You're paying 20,000 rupees and buying a phone. The very simple things like Wi-Fi doesn't work. What happens actually? Right? So that means it is not tested properly, right? So you'll have to test every simple thing. And similarly, the phone has too many features, right? Wi-Fi is just a basic thing. There are so many modes of operation it has. And so many concurrencies are there, right? When you are looking at the YouTube, there is something called YouTube paid version, right? YouTube is going on the background. You can do something, it's gone or some app is there. You're playing song in the background, you're browsing in the front, you're playing a game in the other side, or you are doing a projection in your TV. Your YouTube is playing the TV, but your mobile, you are doing something else, correct? There are a lot of use cases like that. Your phone can do a lot of multitasking, correct?
Yes, sir.
Right. Your WhatsApp may be mirrored in your laptop. Your YouTube video may be playing in the your TV. Your mobile phone, you must be doing some gaming, whatnot, actually, right? You can do that, right? I can see three use cases. You can play a YouTube and project it on the TV, right? You have a WhatsApp on your phone. You can access it from your computer through Wi-Fi. And you can still play games on your phone. All the three things are happening parallelly, correct? So if these kind of cases are not tested, what will happen, actually? Tell me. It may not work, right? If it's not tested, it doesn't guarantee. It may work, it may not work, actually, right? It's not guaranteed, right? So you'll have to really make sure that is a higher level of testing. But I'm telling you, very lowest more level of testing. What I told is the use cases. What I told is very, very important. You have to take notes. Yeah, I don't know why I'm talking today all these things. Very high level concepts, right? That's the system level concepts. It's called use cases. Write down, please take a paper and pen and write down, right? So all the possible use cases has to be properly verified. Right, and you write down, you have to imagine how people will use your product. You may not even anticipate that thing when your product comes out in the market, man. And the person is actually about designing the chip. Let's say I was in Qualcomm, I was designing this particular chip, my Moto G6 or Moto G8, whatever, actually, right? So you may not even know what it is, right? So how people will use your chip or how people use your software, right? You have no idea. But still, you have to anticipate, you have to at least you have to define in your data sheet or whatever document you release a customer, you tell this use case is verified, it's working. Other combinations, I don't guarantee, you should tell, right? So the customer uses other funky combinations, like told three cases, right? The customer still uses that is his problem. No, you're not guaranteeing that to work. Agreed? Right? When you buy a shirt, right? They'll say, don't dry this, don't put the cloth in a dry hot sun. It should be in the shade. You buy expensive shirt or sari, right? Then there'll be some instruction for wash, they'll be there, correct? What they will say, don't put this in sun, put it in the shade, correct? So if you go and put still, yes, put in the sun, if you still go and put in the sun, you cannot go and blame that. You cannot ask a warranty. Say don't put it in the washing machine. They'll say you only hand wash only, they will say. That's a silk saris or whatever, right? So you have to follow the instructions. If that guy doesn't put the instruction, if you buy a 10,000 rupees sari and he doesn't put instruction, you go and put in the washing machine, get spoiled, can go and ask him. But instead of, if you put, that guy has put instruction, only hand wash only, dry it only in the shade. But if you don't follow that, then who can help you, right? If you go and put in you're too lazy, you put it in your washing machine and wash that, they go and dry it in the hot sun. Then your sari gets spoiled, then no, you cannot go back to that guy, right? So that has to be documented in the product manual. What are the use cases? What is working, right? Everything of those will be documented. All these types of features will be thoroughly tested. Right? No, I'm not even going to that. I'm talking about the code level testing, right? One is a code level code coverage. There's another thing called functional coverage. Functional about functionality. You'll have 10 features or 100 features. Mobile, how many features the mobile phone has, man? Do you know? We don't know, right? Have you seen the mobile phone boxes? Right? Can you pick up the boxes or one of the boxes here? Let me read. Read out for us. I'm asking if you should read a mobile box. I have a few mobile boxes at home. What is written? Have you all seen the features listed in the mobile boxes, right? Or you throw the box when you buy a mobile phone?
While purchasing.
So you should read out. You unmute yourself, read out, Ishwar. Is there something written, features? Yeah, specs, exactly. Yeah. So Ishwar is going to read out for us. Yes, I can. You miss.
I have a box for Redmi 2 phone. Surprisingly, I still have it.
Good man.
Okay, so tech specs for this is Qualcomm Snapdragon 410 quad core 1.2 gigahertz processor, 2 GB LPDDR3 RAM.
Hold on. Okay.
Yeah, so he told two features. He told what is the processor, what is the speed of the processor, what is the cache sizes, right? So that has to be verified. Up to what speed the processor can work? How many cores are there? All the folks are working? How many combinations are possible? You have 4 processor cores, 2 to 4 combinations, right? 16 combinations you have to check. So all the software, all applications you run, that is right. You have tested 16 combinations. And cache memories. You told there's any cache sizes. What is the size you told? Sure, cache size.
2 GB RAM.
What is the cache size? Okay, 2 GB RAM means you should check all the 2 GB address spaces available or not. You have to check all the memories ordered in terms of banks. We'll talk about DRAM, we'll talk about it, right? Memories ordered in terms of pages and banks. So you have to make sure that all those transactions are covered, for all the address bits are toggling. The entire thing has been tested or not, right? So these are all like functional coverage and code is very, very important when you verify the things, right? So I think it's very, very important. I'll upload the notes. It's like we are doing a verification class today, right? So you have to verify all the features. Let's understand other features. You should go ahead.
Okay, so going on. Okay, then 16 GB memory, 11.93 centimeter or 4.7 inches HD IPS display, 1280x720 pixels resolution, supports multi-touch, supports dual SIM card, dual standby, support external memory, micro STDM card up to 32 GB, 2200 mAh battery capacity. Then what is this? 2200/2265 mAh lithium ion polymer battery. Then camera, 8 MP BSI camera with 1080p HD video recording, 2 MP front camera with 720 pixels HD video recording, LED flash. network FDD LTE B3, TD LTE B40, WCDMA B1/8, GSM B38, wireless GPS, AGPS.
Mute yourself, Ishwar. Yeah, see, there are so many features. I had to stop him, right? And if you don't know half of that, what we are not even using our phone that modes. So he's a dual SIM, dual standby. So many features, right? So all those things that will be verified before the phone is launched, right? How do you make sure that all these things are verified? So you should have a proper test plan. What is the test plan? So each one of those features, we should have a test cases to test it. And all the concurrences, what can work together, what cannot work together, right? All the possible permutation and combination, you have studied in the mathematics. In the college also, you have studied, right? All of you had mathematics courses in your class. And in college and school, you would have studied. The college also, you would have taught, right? You have statistics, there's a paper combinations, right? You have in college? Any of you have permutation combination in the engineering?
Yes, sir. We had it in 11th or 12th.
Not in the engineering, right?
No, not in the engineering.
Okay. So the probability
will get, sir.
Probability, yeah. Probability must be, that's very, statistics and probability is a very important concept. Yeah. So the probability, this all, whatever tell, like, you know, all the possible combinations has to be fully verified. Otherwise, your phone will not work. We don't know how the customer is going to use it. That's why he's documenting all these features, right? And then if you go to the website, he'll have a user guide, user manual, something like that. That'll be even more exhaustive. Right? Go and look at the phone. What are the, he'll say, under this temperature, it'll work. Under this voltage, it'll work. Right? He'll put so many ifs and buts conditions, right? Because he wants to protect himself. Right? All those conditions he would have tested, and he's putting his limits. So you have to verify so many levels of testing. You have to verify at the block level. Like this one particular, your state machine is one block. There's a data path. There's a module. Then there's a one hierarchy, then the final top level, right? That's a chip, added chip you have to verify. Once you get manufactured a chip, even chip, you know, the RTL, then the gate level simulation you have to verify. After you do the place and route and everything, right? You get the actual timing information. Then only you know the process is going to 1.4 gigahertz or not, correct? They'll tell you what is the gate level simulation. Does all of you understand what is gate level simulation?
They're converting the diagram into gates, sir.
That is a net synthesis process, right? So I told you in the RTL simulation there is no delays available, right? Because this can run at any speed, even 1 terahertz also it can run RTL. There's no, this all code, right? This is behavioral, right? So there's no timing information available. Agree? Right? So when you do synthesis, it converts into the gates. So that also there is no timing information available, right? But still the gates. But they'll be having unit delays, and but only thing it's instead of behavioral RTL, there'll be some structural RTL will be there. That's all. That's the only difference, right? I think I'll show you some examples, but I'll have to show. Maybe I'll Google it and show you some structural code example, what it is, right? Or I'll open the Samil Palitkar book and show it to you, right? So something called structural, how the netlist will look like. I'll show you one of the netlists. We'll see very soon, right? So after that, you do something called floor planning. You do something called routing. Do a clock routing, you do all those things. I told you, so 4 or 5 steps in physical design, right? I think I remember posted one thing in your other what is that group? And I made a short 5-minute video and posted also for the webinar. What are the various ASIC methodologies? What are the various steps, right? I didn't talk about physical design, but I put a lot of steps there, right? So when you actually do a placement, you get some delays. When you do the clock routing, you get some delays. When you do the routing, you get most of the delays, right? So how the delay comes is based on the RC information, right? Any delay in a circuit, it's all based on wire. You have wire delays and gate delays. I remember telling in the first class, correct? There's something called a gate delay. There's something called net delay or wire delay. If you go below 28 nanometer, your net delay will start dominating the gate delay. You know why? Why is that your wire delays or net delays? Wire delay and net delay both are same. The wire delay or net delay will start dominating the gate delays. If you go below certain technology like 28 nanometer. Why is that? Okay, let me explain. That's because you are shrinking the die, right? 28 becomes 20 or 14 or 8 or 5 or 3, whatever, right? Your die size keeps reducing. Your gate starts, let's say you have one design. Let's say one Snapdragon design you have, certain features. So that's going to take you, that's one particular die, right? Now you shrink it. That is taking 1 mm square by 1 mm square, let's assume. Now you are making that from 28 nanometer to 14 nanometer.
So ideally, it should become half, right? 1 nanometer should 1 mm by 1 mm should become 0.5 to 0.5. It may not become 0.5 exactly. It may somewhere land at 0.65 by 0.65. You reduce the size, correct? You are packing. Your technology going to higher technology. Your resource being drained and source is becoming small, correct? So either in the same space you can put more logic, or in a small space you can put the same logic, correct? Agreed. Guys, I want feedback.
Yes, sir.
Raise the hand if you don't understand. One person doesn't understand. Very good. Yeah, please tell me, man. If you don't understand, it's okay to tell, no? Okay, let me repeat. I don't mind repeating 10 times, man. It's okay to repeat. Unless you tell you don't understand, how do I know, right? I will assume everything is going okay. No, I told you, it's not like a class. You cannot dare to ask your professor to questions. Like, you know, when some people may be happy to explain, but some people will not even encourage also, right? So this is it. So you have a 28 nanometer chip with a Snapdragon phone with all the modem, Wi-Fi modem, whatever you should do, the specs, right? That is implemented 28 nanometer device. It's changing 1 mm square by 1 mm square. That is your die size. You know, how big is 1 mm, you know, right? How much, this much? Whatever, you look at the scale, 1 mm by 1 mm. That is the size of that particular chip. I'm assuming, giving some example, right? You're putting some 3 billion transistors, let us assume, right? And so when you say 28 nanometer, what does the 28 nanometer mean? That is basically distance between the drain and source of the CMOS transistor. Right? Agreed? Correct, right?
Yeah, channel length.
What is the channel length between source and drain, right? The channel forms between source and drain, correct?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Yeah. So that is the channel length. Yeah. So now what is it? You have 1 mm square, you have the entire Snapdragon 410. That's what he said, Rajeshwar. Snapdragon 410 is implemented 1 mm square, 1 mm square. It's occupying completely. Right? I'm trying to think of a good analogy to tell you. All right, what is the analogy? I don't know, man. Yeah, I think we should let me think. Maybe I'll get the answer. So you are going into 14 nanometer, right? So your 14 nanometer is like half of the 28 nanometer. Your transistor dimensions reduce, right? 28 nanometer between source and the channel length becomes now 40 half, correct? So what will happen? The same space, 1 mm square, 1 mm square. Ideally, you can pack twice the number of transistors. True or false?
True, sir.
Can you repeat, sir?
In 28, let's assume in 28 nanometer device, let's assume you are having 1 million transistors in 28 nanometer node. When you go to 14 nanometer node, when you go to 14 nanometer node, ideally you can have 2 million transistors.
Yeah, twice as much, right?
Right, as much. Ideally, you know, it may not be, ideally I'm saying, it's not theoretical. Practically, it may be some, there's something called efficiency, right? Make it 70%, 65%, whatever actually.
Yeah, maybe less, just less than 20 million or something.
Whatever, yeah, there's something called efficiency. It cannot be ideal actually. It's always some ballpark, something will be there. It'll be some 60% of that or 70%. At least it'll be 50% more actually, right? If it is 1 million transistor in 28, you can at least do 1.5 million in the same size, right? Correct?
Yes, sir.
Right. Or what you can do is you can also shrink the size. Instead of 1 mm square, I can make 0.5. Because your transistor size is decreasing, your die size can reduce. I can do it by 0.5 mm square, by 0.5 mm square, I can do it, right? Previously it was 1 mm square, now we can do it as a 0.5 mm square. Agree?
Yes, sir.
So what is a good analogy for that? Can you think of some analogy?
Analogy in terms of day-to-day life?
Yeah, exactly, yeah. So that everybody understands the concept. Yeah, I think we all understand. I think still I'm not getting a good example to show you, but do you all understand what I mean?
Yes, sir. We're thinking about the analogy.
Yeah, okay. Forget about analogy, but have you understood the concept?
Yes, sir. I understood the concept.
All of you here, anyone doesn't understand, please raise your hand. You sure understood? Okay. So that is the difference. I think where I started, I don't know. So, okay. So basically, I think I know I got the where I started from. So, you know, so the same design, you can pack in half the die size now, right? That's what we are concluding. You pack in half the die size. So what happens, your number of transistors are still same, correct? I'm using the same design, the Snapdragon 410. Now it is implemented a lower technology. That means you are from 1 mm square and come to 0.5 mm square, correct? That means your gates are going to sit close by each other. right? It's like this, man. I'll give you another good analogy, right? You have a room, your classroom. Your 60 people are sitting in the classroom. Okay. Now you have got a smaller class, half the size. Right? Still 60 of you have to sit. What will happen? There is no social distancing. All of you had to hug each other and stand in the place. Or what? On to start on your feet, and some of you have to do very close, right? Correct? That is analysis.
Yes, sir.
You have a very comfortable classroom, and all of you are they're maintaining social distance of 10 feet, and you're sitting in the class. Now you are saying, something happened in the class, you're going to a smaller classroom, but all 60 of you have to sit in the same class. So you all come together, correct? Right? Previously, the class, there's a 10 feet distance. If you talk very mild tone, you try and tell, other guy will understand, he will not understand, correct?
Right? Yes, sir.
You're whispering something, other guy may not know. Now you are sitting close by, you are whispering the same speed, other guy will definitely understand, correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
You all got the concept, that is a concept,
yes, sir.
Right? So the whispering is like wire delay, right? Previously you are 5-10 meters apart, there is enough space. No, so there is some amount of delay. Now you are coming crowded. In this area become less, so you are more crowded, right? Now you whisper, it is very clearly visible. So your net delay is also dominating that, right? Your number of gates are same, they're tightly packed. So the routes going from one place to other place, that is also becoming equivalent to the gate delay. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
So that's why I'm saying the wire delays also will dominate when you go to lower technologies. Correct? These are the issues what you find in the deep submicron technologies. Right? I think probably I wrote a presentation paper long back actually. For challenges of deep submicron technology. So this is one of the challenges. Your leakage power is one of the challenges. I think somebody asked a question in the last webinar. Right? Leakage power is a challenging. Because your threshold voltage keeps reducing, your power keeps reducing. Right? We cannot run the device at the same power. 28 nanometer takes like 1 volt. When you run in 14 nanometer, you cannot give 1 volt supply actually, right? Your transistor size is reducing. What will happen if you give 1 volt power? It will get burnt out for a period of time. The yield issues will come, right? I think I spoke about this in all the classes. You know what is the yield, right? I spoke. There will be something called yield. And you can apply the same voltage, you will get burnt out, right? Let's say I'm telling Ishwar every day, Ishwar, you have to study, Ishwar, you have to study. I'm just yelling at him every day. So if you do it for 1 month, what will happen to Ishwar? You say get lost, right? Ishwar, yes or not? You'll say, right? All of you will say that, man. We're all human beings, right? I say every day I come and trouble you. I keep shouting at the entire class every day. I use bad words. After 1 month, we'll come to my class. No, right?
No, sir.
You won't come to my class, obviously, right? Yes. I won't do. I'm learning from somebody, he has so great knowledge, but he's yelling at me. Why would I go? Everyone has self-respect, right? Why would you go? Even people do mistakes, you cannot yell at them these days, right? People don't like it, right? All of you will also have self-respect, right? Let's say somebody has done mistake. You say, I'm sorry, I'm calling. Let me use Ishwar's name. Ishwar did a mistake. I'm going and yelling at him. He may not like it, right? But that is a fact. But no, it's the way you have to accept. He may like it, he may not like it, right? It's all human beings. But nobody likes to accept their own mistakes, right? It's very genuine people only accept the mistakes, right? That's a human psychology, man. I'm not blaming people. That's how the human brain works. So, why you never use the name why, I told him. You talk about why, what, and all, right? When you told, why Ishwar? Why did you do that? I asked him, he'll go into defensive mode immediately. Correct? And this other should tell you, help me understand Ishwar. How, what happened? Please help me understand. Same thing, you are asking different way. Correct? So, that's how you have to talk. Right? I think let me come back to the original thing, right? So wire delays are getting dominated. Similarly, the leakage power also. When you say power, right? When the power is, you have to keep the same power. You're giving more stress to the transistors. Transistor size has reduced. So you're applying the same power, you'll get burnt out. That is analogy. I gave a good analogy, right? Of yelling at you, the class, or yelling at somebody. Even if you're not making mistake, somebody else at you get into defensive, right? Same way, right? So transistors also, then you have to reduce the voltage so that it doesn't get stressed, correct? So you have to reduce the voltage. Okay. So then, the leakage also comes in basically, right? I think we have to go to CMOS fundamentals, talk about why the leakage is more dominant when you kind of reduce it, nanometer, right? I think probably I should find out some good videos in the YouTube and send it. There's a lot of interesting video lectures, right? Yeah, ideally I want to sit and do such videos sometime, but probably I'll find time sometime, right? So very interesting concept. So we will talk about entire leakage current very soon. Maybe one month or 2 months, we'll definitely talk about it. Right? Or at least in 6 months. We definitely are going to go, like, no, it's very interesting, believe me, right? We'll go and talk about all these things, right? So, yeah, provided you follow my instructions, I'll put the disclaimer now onwards. Unless you guys do all the homework, this class is not going to move now. I'm going to gate the progress, man. That's what I have to do, right? All of you have to finish homework. I'm telling you from next on, tomorrow onwards, like the FPGA class start, I'll not start the Verilog classes. I'll put other people on hold also. You have to practice Verilog, complete all the labs. You sit with each other, whatever you want, you finish the labs, then only we'll go ahead. Okay, so Sajid, let me come back. So that is called a threshold voltage, right? So all the wire delay, everything is getting dominant when you come here. You know, I have to come back, I have to pop memory and see where I started. I think it's not about the coverages, use cases, and then so I landed here. I think I got diverted, right? So I was talking about features. I talk about the timing, right? That's why we came to all these things, right? When you do the routing, then only get the RC delays. Then only you know the design is working at 1.5 megahertz or 1.4 or 1.6. Right, I think I told you about how to model the best case delays and worst case delays in one of the classes, right? Remember, in the delays, how to model the Verilog delays, correct? Worst case and best case. Remember, yes. I told you when it will be, I told you the same example I told you about when the RC delays will come. Some you'll get a best case, worst case, I explained all those things. If you have written notes, you'll understand, right? So go and at least look at the videos. You're fortunate to have the videos, go and look at those videos. Or if you have notes, you go and look at the notes. Revise all those things, right? I've explained all the concepts already. I'm explained again today. So when you do the complete gate level simulation with, it's called SDF annotated, standard delay format it's called, right? So that only gives, then only you get the timing information. You have to route the design. You extract the RC values from there. It's called extraction. We call SPEF. That's not the keyword what you use in the physical design, SPEF. Whatever it means, I have no idea. We call SPEF. You extract the SPEF from the your routed database. And then you convert that into SDF format. Then the SDF file will get annotated on your gate level netlist. You run simulations and you use the same test bench. It's the same test bench what we have here, right? Use the same test bench and it will work. It should work. And now it will show you what speed it works, basically. Right? It works at 1 megahertz. Again, when you go to the FPGA class, we'll see all those things. I'll demonstrate what speed it FPGA works. 10 megahertz, 100 megahertz, all those things we'll know. We'll implement your counter, we'll see what speed it works. You can do gate level simulations, right? But unless you complete these labs, how can you know help go to the, how do you do gate level simulations? You don't need to know how to write a test bench in Verilog. How can you do gate level simulations, right? Without studying LKG, how can you go to UKG, right? It's the same way, right? So that's how the RC delay, everything comes. That's how the timing gets verified, right? We'll come back. My original thing, I think we have to end in 3 minutes or we have to end in 5 minutes. We start a little bit late, right? So all the possible combinations, this is called code coverage, right? This is called state machine coverage. This is expression coverage, sorry. This is expression coverage, state machine coverage, S0, S1, state machine coverage. This is branch coverage and toggle coverage. If the clock is toggling or not, reset is toggling or not, right? And if there's a, this register, LA is good. All the 2 bits are toggling. There are 4 combinations, right? 2 bits. All the 4 combinations of LA is happening or not. LB4 combinations are happening or not. This is called toggle coverage. These 3 bits, see here? All the 4 combinations of Q has happened or not. All the 4 combinations of TB has happened or not. All the 4 combinations of TA happened or not. The tool will check all those things automatically. Now I'm saying you do the exercises manually for this lab. You do it yourself, then your test bench will become exhaustive. Right? I want each one of you to do this. Take this state machine example, traffic control example. And make sure that your test bench is exhaustive. Right? That's what I'm telling. Pick up at least one example, make sure that the test bench is exhaustive, covering all the combinations. And that's why I will be doing my reviews. When you come to me, otherwise I'm going to send you back. So that's where I started. I think you learned a lot of new things, unplanned things, man. I think I should come unprepared to the class. You learn more in that way, right? Correct? You agree, guys? Was this class interesting?
Yes, sir. It was interesting. May not be always, but yeah, it was interesting.
Yeah, but otherwise I come with the slide. I prepare. You go by that, right? I think I went. I had a free mind, and it went wherever it went. There's no constraints, right? I don't know how much you followed, but. Yeah, please raise your hand now. All of you follow whatever I said 100%. I want to get some feedback. 1, 2, 3, 4. Bhuvanesh is not raising hands. Bhuvanesh raised. Ishwar is not raising. You didn't follow Ishwar? Ishwar has not followed. Balaji has not followed. Balaji raised his hands. Ishwar, Girish, have you followed?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, Ishwar, what you didn't follow?
think I followed this a lot. I haven't followed totally.
Why? You're not able to concentrate. Huh? Am I going too fast?
This thing I understood somewhat. Like that, whatever you said, it's gone over my head.
Very good. Okay. So I need to understand. So Ishwar didn't understand everything. So I think, yeah, one of you have to talk to Ishwar offline. So who is volunteering? So Ishwar has some doubts. He's not followed everything. He's all went over the head. Right? I'll pause the video recording. I'll share you some interesting things. What happened yesterday? You know, and yeah, you laughed at me. I think, yeah, you can relate to tomorrow's webinar also. I'll share a secret. Because I treat all of my friends. Right? So I'll share that secret. Okay. So who wants to help Ishwar? Yeah, you will help yourself, but no, I want somebody to help Ishwar. What, in that way, you will also understand then only, right? When you go and talk to Ishwar. Girish, how about you? Silence.
Okay, sir.
Try it out.
Okay, sir.
You try, you will get doubts. See, the best thing you do, when you discuss, then you will get doubts. It's natural to get doubts. I don't expect you to understand. You will be genius if you understood everything what I said in this call, man. I would say that, to be honest. Right? I won't expect you to understand all the 100, but you go and look at the video, play it 10 times and read it. It's a very, very important class, right? So I want to talk about DRAM, but I ended up talking about verification today, right? So that's why I'm saying you should not prepare slides. You just go randomly and probably you get more knowledge. And good that you got recorded, right? So you watch through the video and you learn, right? But I'm very serious. End of day, I want all of you to commit by this Sunday evening, 7 p.m., right? I want all of you to reply the email. Look at all the lab classes available, what the Bhuvanesh or Balaji documented there. There's a lot of labs I've given in the last few classes. So can Balaji or Bhuvanesh overgave that? Can you take responsibility to document rest of the labs? Make it completely updated, right? And my expectation is that at least for the state machine class, the code coverage has to be done manually. So whatever conditions I told you, every single bit has to be toggling. There should be a toggle coverage. There should be something called a code coverage. There's something called as state machine coverage. There's something called expression coverage. All those four coverages has to happen. If you're defining a bit, 4-bit, all the two rest of the 4 bits of 16 combination has to be covered on all the three variables here, right? If you have state machine coverage, all the possible state transitions to be covered. S0 to S, you draw in the paper, you draw it. S0 to S0, S0 to S1, S1 to S1, S1 to S2, like so on. All the combinations has to be verified, right? So everywhere, all the combinations has to be verified. So then only I will going to accept your design. You do it manually. The tool will do it automatically. You don't do it for it. It's painful. I understand. But once you learn to do it manually, it'll be easy for you to analyze it. When the tool tells, oh, this code coverage is only 90%, it will tell. So some branch is not executed. If you do it manually, then you can, it's like riding a bicycle and driving a car, right? Or riding a bike. If you know how to ride a bicycle, then riding a bike is or a scooter is easier. If you don't know how to ride a bicycle, still you can ride a bike, but it's difficult, right? It takes time to learn, to become expensive affair. Right? If you do know how to analyze this manually, when the tool runs actually, then becomes you can easily analyze it and go and fill it and you can do it to your job faster. You'll understand the concepts. That's why I'm telling you to do this manually. Okay. So all of you are going to apply this concept on the traffic light controller example. Okay, and wherever possible, when you apply. I mean, when you say go, this is how you have to know. Have you verified all the combinations? I ask every time. I probably go over send me assignments. I ask Yogesh. I think I ask somebody else also. Have you verified all possible conditions? You say yes. Now you apply this concept. This is what I mean. When you say all possible combinations, this is what I had in mind. Now you know, go and think, have you verified all combinations? Answer is no. Correct? So you have to verify that way. Your verification has to be bulletproof. If you have all these kinds of people, love you, man. They'll hire you. I'm saying even you, before finishing course, you'll get I can get you a job. If you understand all these concepts. So two in the third year, actually, right? Right? So that's what it is. Okay. So let me go offline. So I want to share a couple of feedback with you. I'll ask you some questions. Maybe I'll want to do an interview. I think I did interview some people today. I want to do that. How do you stop recording?